Good morning, everybody, and welcome to this morning's update on today's severe weather threat. So the Storm Prediction Center has expanded the moderate risk of severe weather to include areas like Oklahoma City, Norman, Tulsa, and Fort Sill, Oklahoma, in the red area today. We have an enhanced risk of severe weather that has also been expanded into southeastern Kansas, including Wichita, and into western and southwestern Missouri, including Springfield as well. We have a slight risk in the yellow area today and a marginal risk in the dark green. And looking at the tornado threat has increased across the southwestern quarter of Oklahoma, where we have a 10% chance now of tornadoes of touching down within 25 miles of a location in this yellow area. And this is bordering on Fort Sill, Oklahoma, and this area is hatched. So that means EF2 or stronger tornadoes are possible in this small little area this evening. We have a 5% tornado risk within 25 miles of a location in the brown area. This includes Woodward, Norman, Oklahoma City, Fort Sill, Wichita Falls, and Tulsa, and a 2% chance of tornadoes touching down within 25 miles of a location in the green area today. So make sure you watch out for a few tornadoes in the brown area, and an isolated tornado in the green area, and a couple strong tornadoes in the yellow area today. Looking at the wind risk, this is by far the most dangerous aspect of the storm. A widespread damaging straight-line wind event is expected today with this, and we have expanded the 45% wind risk area to include Fort Sill, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa, Oklahoma as well, in the pink area, and the 30% chance of damaging winds within 25 miles of a location has expanded to include Wichita, Kansas, and Springfield, Missouri. The hatched area represents a 10% chance of seeing 75 mile per hour hurricane force winds are stronger within 25 miles of a location, and I believe that a derecho is going to be possible today across these areas. So make sure you're preparing now for a widespread damaging wind event if you live in the pink area, the red area, and the hatched area. We have a 15% risk in the yellow and a 5% risk in the brown. And finally, looking at the hail threat remains a lot lower than the wind threat, with only a 15% chance of quarter-size hail within 25 miles of a location across portions of northwest Texas, central western Oklahoma, south central Kansas in the yellow, with a 5% hail risk in the brown area today. So looking at the latest timing of the storms, the HRR model around 4 o'clock central standard time, we're not going to be seeing much thunderstorm development at 4 o'clock. But going into 5 o'clock, we're going to be seeing initiation across southwest Kansas, the Oklahoma and Texas panhandles. And as we go into 6 o'clock, the storms are going to really start to blossom across southwest Kansas, western Oklahoma, and the Texas panhandle. And then as we go into 7 o'clock, this has changed a little bit from yesterday, which is why they've increased the tornado threat. We're now seeing more individual and separated cells in the high-resolution model than we were yesterday. So this is why the Storm Prediction Center has increased the tornado probabilities across much of central western Oklahoma, and especially southwest Oklahoma and northwest Texas in the Childress area for this evening. And then going into 8 o'clock, we see a band of embedded supercells now across western Oklahoma, and these could be producing tornadoes, very strong damaging winds, and even some hail by 8 p.m. in the Woodward, Oklahoma area. Going into 9 o'clock, very intense storms are moving across west central Oklahoma into the Altus area, and then going into 10 p.m. central standard time tonight, we should be full-on linear mode with very strong damaging winds up and down the line from Wichita, Kansas to El Reno into southwest Oklahoma, maybe even Wichita Falls getting in on the action by 10 p.m. this evening. And then the storms are going to blast through Oklahoma City with 70 to 75 mile per hour winds likely around between 10 and 11 this evening. Very intense line from Wichita, Kansas, just east of there, down to the Red River. Going into midnight, the storms are going to be moving through Tulsa and areas like McAllister. And then as we go into 1 a.m. and 2 a.m., the storms will push through Kansas City and Joplin, Missouri, and Springfield, Missouri, around 3 and 4 a.m. Tonight. So looking at the NAMNES model, starting at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we're going to be seeing widespread storm initiation around 6 o'clock in the Texas Panhandle, Oklahoma Panhandle, southwest Kansas. And then going into 7 o'clock, we're going to be seeing a broken line of storms with potential supercells in southeastern areas of the Texas Panhandle. And then going into 8, 9 o'clock, this model is still keeping some supercells on the southwestern edge of the line as late as 9 and 10 o'clock this evening, which is why that 10% significant tornado risk has been added for this area this evening. And then going into 10 o'clock, the storms are still going to be approaching Oklahoma City from the west, and still we could be seeing discrete cells on the southern part of the line. And then going into 11 p.m., the storms are going to push through Oklahoma City and Wichita in the NAMNES model. And then by 1 a.m. through Tulsa, and then by 2 a.m. through Joplin and Kansas City, and by around 4 a.m. Springfield. So this is going to be a very dangerous, damaging wind event. Make sure you're preparing now if you live especially in the moderate and enhanced risk areas for widespread, dangerous, damaging winds of hurricane force or stronger. Make sure you have your NOAA Weather Radio handy for the latest severe weather and tornado warnings. And stay indoors during the duration of the event. Stay safe and have a wonderful day, my friends.